Okay.
Good evening, YouTube. Well, we are in the middle of a week of constant rain to the point where the past hour it was raining so hard that the rain is overflowing our gutters. Right about this point, Heidi at Rain Country Homestead is probably laughing, saying, "Welcome to the club." But wanted to do a seed saving video. Now the process is the same for both dandelion and colt's foot. Now just this past week, on Monday, I got permission from the landowner next door to dig up and transplant some colt's foot that he had growing at the side of his parking or machinery parking area at the farm. As a matter of fact, it was in a place where he normally parks a piece of machinery, so I had to get it out before he moved that piece of machinery back for the summer. And so we dug it up and transplanted it day before yesterday, and I'll show you that now. Well, this is colt's foot. You can see all the flower heads have been popped off, and some of them have gone to seed and blown away. The flower is very much like dandelion. A little bit of red or orange tint to the outside of the petals. And the leaves are very much like either garlic mustard or wild ginger. You can see here the garlic mustard, the flowers are considerably different. And there's some garlic mustard here as well, growing up out of the patch of wild ginger. And I don't see a flower on that at all to show you the difference. It's got a sort of orchid-like flower, but not very pretty, sort of a brownish orchid flower. So for the colt's foot here, it's the leaves that you use. You dry them, and they are good for removing a phlegm buildup in your lungs, apparently. I haven't tried it yet, and I'm not a doctor, so I'm not going to say that this is going to work for anyone, but this is the plan. The seeds for colt's foot work the same way just about as the seeds for dandelions. Now everybody knows dandelions. I had to run out and grab these when the rain started, so none of them are completely full, but everybody knows dandelion seeds. They're always blowing around in the wind. And the little umbrella part is their method of travel, and the seed is the little piece at the end. So to harvest and store the seed, you need to get just that part of it.
Focus. Focus.
3D House of Seeds. Mwahahaha.
boot going to move of its own violin. Okay.
So, what do you do to harvest... to harvest and keep the seeds for dandelion? What I'm going to show you is one of the approved methods, might be the only approved method, it's the only one I read about, for harvesting milkweed seeds. Fundamentally clean dandelion seed. But if I had been thinking, I would have grabbed a funnel to do this in, to get this into the bag with. There we go. Reasonably clean milkweed, or milkweed, dandelion seed. Whoop. Ready to be thrown on the floor. So, again, just in case that didn't focus very well. Not trying to burn or singe the seed, just all the umbrellas that it has ready to transport its seed. And you pick off just the seed. Now, I generally prefer to store seeds in paper envelopes and then ship seeds if I'm shipping them in these plastic bags. Long-term storage, I guess, is preferable in the plastic bags. But generally, when I first harvest seeds, I keep them in paper envelopes so that they can continue to dry and not go moldy. So that's dandelion seed. Now, you may have, you noticed in my in the clip about the Colts foot that all the seed heads had been popped off. We did that as we were digging them up. I can get something out of here without sending all the seeds flying. Now these, unfortunately, were not as dry as they could have been when we picked them. But with a little bit of perseverance and a watchful eye, should be able to get off the majority of the fluff. Without physically cooking the seeds. So we'll get the rest of these done and packaged up, and Heidi, I'll get a bunch of these out in the mail to you as soon as possible. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.